Hello and welcome to another Radio Redux Guest Control Arm Archange UK. What I've got for you today is something different in that it's not really a radio show. It's actually a very long recording of an interview. Back in, let's say, beginning of 2008, as part of the Knights Journey of Dreams celebration, Takashi Iizuka, who you all may know as one of the founding fathers, if you like, of Sonic, and also probably the head of Sonic Team and also the Sonic Committee in the present day, came over to Europe as part of a tour, and to UK specifically, to promote Knights Journey of Dreams. Obviously, Journey of Dreams being perhaps the last... Yes, it was actually. It was the last game produced by Sonic Team USA. Now, everyone really had... Anyone had some time to do interview and ask questions, I think, and we were up last. We, being myself, I was there mainly representing the Knights guys. I was representing Trippy and Digi and KnightsIntoDreams.com, who couldn't come down, rather unfortunately. Mike Taylor is there, representing Sonic Cage Dome, and, but also actually there on the behest of Nintendo Life. And the recording is actually being made by Graham Cookson, who you may know as G from SegaNerd's website. It was us three, and we sat down and interviewed Takashi Iizuka and asked very much more in-depth and revealing questions than I would have thought he was familiar with from, let's say, the other interviewers who were there. I had a big list of questions from the Knights fan base, all of which were very, very technical and in-depth. And there is one point where I literally feared for my job, because I asked a question about the mysterious missing boss from the original Knights into Dreams, and it gets quite a reaction, because I don't think Iizuka-san really realised that everyone else was aware that they knew that boss had existed. So this is a great thing where the translator is having a big conversation with Iizuka-san about how the hell they know that, and it's good fun. It is good fun. So I will leave you with that, and the rest. There's no music on this one. This is purely listen to this if you are interested in hearing what Takashi Iizuka has to say. But essentially, hey, I had Takashi Iizuka on my show. Sweet.
Do you want to introduce yourselves first?
I'm Graham Cookson from Sega Nerds, from the website.
I'm Kevin Eber, I'm the online community manager here at Sega Europe. Mm-hmm. I'm actually representing the main Knights fan site, KnightsIntoDreams.com.
My name's Mike Taylor, I'm from Nintendo Life. Well, that's who I'm from today. I do other Sonic fan site stuff as well.
Okay.
I'll start with your question. I was wondering when development for Journey Dream started. How long ago? How long has it been in development for?
まあ、いつから始めたのかとどれぐらいかかりましたか。
そうです。 2年ぐらい前にナイツのシークルを作ろうと思い立って、でそれから実際ゲームデザインとかを始めてからは1年半ぐらいのデベロップメントスケジュールです。
started the actual development process like 1.5 years ago from now.
When the original Knights had like come out and everybody had played it, there was rumours a few months later about a sequel then, so 6 years ago, I say. It's called Air Knights. Do you know anything about that? Or Air Knights is a rumored name.
Ah, Air Knights?
Yeah. There's a concept of motion control all those years ago.
Is
it true or does that have any bearing on the game now? Or?
シークエルを作るっていうつもりでそのエアナイツっていうのが始まったわけではなくて、まあ、あくまでもそのセガのモーションコントローラーを試験的に作った時があって、まあ、それのように、まあ、ナイツのプログラムを使って 3D で実際こうモーションコントローラーで飛行するっていうのプロトタイプを作ったっていうのがエアナイツです。
At this time, Sega had been testing motion control in Sega company, and he created Air Knights for prototypes. It's just a prototype, so not any new relation to with the Knights sequel. Just prototypes didn't happen.
Okay.
How did you come up the idea for the My Dream part of the game?
My Dream っていうのは、そもそも前作にあった A ライフっていうキャラクターがいたんですけども、まあ、その A ライフとは実際そのゲーム中ミッションやってる最中にしか彼らと触れ合う機会がなかった。それをもっと彼らと時間を気にせずに触れ合うような、まあ、新たな場所を用意してあげようと思ってスタートしたのがマイドリーム。で、まあ、そもそも A ライフっていうもののコンセプトは、A ライフというもののコンセプトは、まあ、開発者ですらも知らないようなことが起こるっていう、そういうところにあるので、そのマイドリームというその世界も A ライフのコンセプト同様に開発者が決めた世界を作るわけではなくて、もう A ライフたちによってそこに何が起こるかわからない、どんな地形になるかわからないっていう、そういうコンセプトでマイドリームができている。
In original night, there was also A life creatures. But you could only communicate with them during the mission. So he wanted to make some place in Journey of Dreams to communicate with Elite even out of the missions.
Okay.
So that's why he created My Dream. And the concept of Elite is the concept of Elite is and he thought that what the most interesting thing is of ALF is that even developers can expect what will happen in my dream. So that's the main concept of
A ライフのキーポイントですね。
That's the key point. The most key point, the most important key point of A ライフ feature. The key thing.
だから、マイドリームっていうそのフィールド、ワールドの方も同様に開発者が作ったものではなくて、勝手に生成される、自分自身で生成される、そういう何が起こるかわからないような世界を作りたかった。
And he wanted to create a field that he never can expect what will happen in the world in my dream. That's what he wanted to do in Journey of Dreams.
Okay. Why did you decide to give Knights a voice?
A voice?
Yeah.
No.
And why did you choose a female voice as well?
あの、まあ、ナイツっていうのは前作でも一応あのボイスアクションボイスがあったので、まあ、今回は実際のゲームの中でもストーリーを充実させるという意味で、まあ、当然だからオリジナルナイツでも喋ってたわけで、うん、だ今回もそのストーリー上で喋るっていうのはすごく自然な流れとして、まあ、そうなったと、うん、であの声っていうのはナイツの声っていうのはあの、まあ、今実際聞あの声も聞く人によってはあの男の声だっていう人もいるし今のようにフィメールの声だっていう人もいる、うん、っていうのは実際ナイツっていうのは夢の中で自分のも分身なわけで男の子がの夢であればナイツは男の子のように感じるし、うん、女の子の夢であれば女の子のように感じる。だからその性別のない声ということで今の現在の声を選んでいます。
In original Nights, there are also I'm not sure you know this, but there are also the Nights action voice in original Nights.
Nice.
Yeah. So and the reason why he added more Nights voice in Journey of Dreams is to make to help the users understand story more, you know, much easier and.To do more depth of the gameplay, and also he thinks basically the voice is not the knight's gender is not, you know, the knight is neutral character,
yeah.
So doesn't have any gender and can be divided. So it really depends on the people, player who play the knight. If knight if the knight's voice is girl or boy, from the I would say from girl's point of view, knight can be, you know.The character, okay. Female character, and from boy, maybe from boy's point of view, the knight can be, you know, male. So that really depends on the player.
Okay.
Yeah.
will we be able to unlock any other characters or costumes in the game? Like in at Christmas Night, you can play as Sonic.And will there be anything like that in the new game? Any new characters you can play as?
You mean in Journey of Dreams?
Yes, in Journey of Dreams.
New characters?
Hidden characters.
Like
in Christmas Night, you could unlock Sonic. Unlockable content.
まあ、今回そのランクとかあのその繰り返しプレイすることによってまあランクが上がったりっていうフューチャーがあるのでまあいくつかのアンロッカブルフューチャーは用意してます。まあただその何がアンロックされるかっていうのはそれはまあプレイヤーの楽しみでもあるのでまあここであえて何がアンロックされるかっていうのは言わないでおきますと。
Yeah, there will be some unlockable features, but he can't say what it is, because, you know, it's a bit secret. But, by playing the night, this game again and again, get high rankings, player can unlock, unlock features. Secret.
Is there anything you would like to have changed in the game or anything you would like to have added to the final release if you had time?
なんか時間があれば追加したかった要素とかってあります？
追加したかった。いや今はあの本当にだから 当初思っていたそのナイツシークエルっていうのを、まあ、無事完成できたっていう満足感でいっぱいなので、
うん、
あの、まあ、特に今のやつに足すようなことはないですね。
Yeah, he is satisfied with the ninth sequel he just finished created. He thinks he could implement everything he wanted to add and include in Journey of Dreams. So there's not really anything he wanted to add.
Okay. Nothing more he could do.
Hmm?
Nothing more he could do.
He really thinks make the most of Nintendo Wii function in the game, so he really satisfied with it.
What control method do you prefer? Do you prefer the Wii or the Nunchuck?
もちろんアナログスティックでコントロールするのが一番、まあ、ビギナーにとって一番遊びやすいプレイスタイルだと思っているので、まあ、ヌンチャクやフラッシュコントローラー、ね、であと、まあ、もし前作 の、 そのアナログスティックのフィーリングが近いのはあの自分の中ではそのゲームキューブコントローラーがアナログスティックの長さが短い分だけ、まあ、一番フィーリングがオリジナルに近い。で Wii リモートっていうのはあれはその両手でコントロールするっていう従来のやり方とは全く違う飛ぶフィーリングっていうのを実現するためのものであって、あのナイツというゲームに慣れてから、まあそういうちょっと新しい感覚っていうのをまあ慣れたユーザーに体験してもらいたいなと思ってます。
Yeah, he recommends theyou don't recommend that a player use. He thinks that it's really easy for players just to use the analog stick or classic controller to play this game. That you know, if you ever play the original Knight, you may want to use the GameCube controller, because the GameCube controller has kind of similar analog stick.
Yeah.
Yeah, because the kind of length of the analog stick is short and really similar to the Sega Saturn controller. So he recommend it. But he thinks Wii Remote use the completely different gameplay, the feeling of flying. So, but.You know, for beginners, he might not recommend it because it requires technique. So maybe after you're getting used to it.
What is your personal favorite control type? What do you like to use?
実際スコアアタックみたいに正確なコントロールを求めるプレイをするときには今は自分ではヌンチャクやクラシックコントローラーの方を使います。で、もっと気軽に流しプレイ、ただ単にその飛んでクリアだけをするようなゲームプレイの場合はリモコン操作が自分の中では気持ちいいと思ってます。
If he want to try a score attack orscore attack, he thinks classic controller かヌンチャクかということですか。
スコアアタックをするときには普段開発ではゲームキューブコントローラーを使っています
。He plays score attack. The developers in the team usually use game cube controller because it requires really sensitive control. But for him personally, if he want to play, enjoy just feeling of knights flying in the game, he would like to use Wii Remote.
Okay. Did you want to ask me?
Yeah.
Sorry. people have said that Bellbridge has some very London-like tendencies. Uh-huh. Was that very deliberate? And how did you sort of take influence from London, if that's true?
まあ、ナイツっていうのはそもそもオリジナルナイツの時もソニックはすごくアメリカンライクなキャラクターで、ナイツはすごくヨーロッパに向けたタイトルにしたいっていう思いがあったんですね、昔から、うん、で今回もの、ナイツも、その男の子と女の子の住んでいるベルブリッジっていう街は、ヨーロッパにあるどこか架空の街っていう設定にしたいかったので、うん、まあ、街並みは、まあ、ヨーロッパのいろんな国の文化を、まあ、ちょっとずつ入れて、まあ、ヨーロッパっぽい、うん、フィーリングにしてます。
ヨーロッパにあるような街のから、まあ、
実在はしない街だけども
ヨーロッパっぽく、まあ、
ヨーロッパのどこかにありそうな国
ヨーロッパのどこかヨーロッパ
で、なのであえて喋ってる英語もアメリカンイングリッシュじゃなくてブリティッシュイングリッシュにしてる。
Yes, from the very very beginning, for example, he the concept of Sonic, one of the concept of Sonic is to create more like American style game, but for Knight, he wanted to create the more like European style game.
Character.
Yeah, character.
Sonic is more like an American character. And I'd like to create Knight for the European
that specific style.
Yeah,
so he tried to make the stages of which is similar.
Stage じゃない。
So what was とどこかにあそうなまあそういう
ヨーロッパのどこかに住んでいるヘレンとウィル。
そのメインキャラクターの話。
現実世界の話だ。ゲームじゃないか。
Yeah, so yeah, so he also set the character, create the character maybe who might live somewhere in Europe, because and that's why he used British English in the game. You might notice it.
Yeah, the English accent.
Yeah. That's why he chose
it. Just
angry.
We like that. Thank you.
Unsurprisingly. Okay. Compared to the original Knights, how many staff members were working on Journey of Dream?
Journey of Dream?
Original Knights から比べて、まあ要はJourney of Dream は最初から何人のチームで始めたのかっていうことだと思いますけど。
これオリジナルは何？
You mean how many you mean you want to know how many people in the team who created the Journey of Dream? Not original.
ああ、日本アメリカのうちのスタジオには26人。
26 developers in the team.
ね、まあここのアメリカのスタジオで実際の中のゲームのコンテンツを作って。
Yeah, most of the content in Journey of Dream was developed in Sonic Studio USA.
でそれとは別に、まあ、サウンドチームとあと CG ムービーを作るチームが日本に別にいます。
And as for the sound and CG movies are developed in Japan. SOJ とかですかね。SOJ of Japan. Yeah.
Why was Jackal?Not included is the chameleon type boss, is that supposed to be a replacement? And will we see Jackal again? It's their question.
まあ前作で気に入ってる私もその、まあ、ジャックルは好きなんですけど、まあ、前作にいるキャラクターばっかり持ってきちゃったら同じゲームになっちゃいますから、まあ、やっぱり今回新作ということで、まあ、あえてワイズマンとリアラ以外のボスは全部一新してます。
He really likes the character, but if he implemented all similar characters as with the original version, that can be the same game. That will be the same game. So he just chose Wise Man and the other.
So to
add a differentiator.
Right.
Okay.
So this is a new game. Yeah.
That's one of their questions, actually, if it's a new game or if it's a remake, so that answers that. Actually, they do have one, according to the second biggest mystery of Knights. What did the deleted boss self look like?
Deleted?
Do we know? Apparently there was a deleted boss in the original game code for Knights 1 called self.
A deleted
boss character.
Why do you know the boss of self?
They know. I think they.
Who is they?
Their fan. Their fan base knows.
Is it a rumor?
I think so. Probably.
そうです。
事実として、オリジナルナイツにセルフっていうボスを出そうと思ってたんですよ。
それ言っても大丈夫なんですか？
言ってもいいですよ。まあ多分中さんが以前言ってるんですよね、どこかで。
それはなんでじゃあデリートされたのかっていう。
それはだからオリジナルナイツではデリートしたんですけど、デリートしたっていうか当時あのタイトルで完結してたんで、そこにまさもう一つ加える必要はないということで、消した。
It's correct. The self, the character, boss character existed. That and also
In Journey of Dreams, you've got different masks that knights can use. What's your favourite mask?
それぞれ全部使い方が違くて、一番ジェネラルで使えるのはロケットなんですね。で、あれが一番自分の新しい攻略ルートを見つけるという意味で、自分の攻略をクリエイトできるマスクなんです。それが一番ジェネラルで使える。で、あとはドルフィンとドラゴンというのは、あのステージに隠されたアイテムとか隠されたルートっていうのを発見するためのもの。
So he said each remask has different characteristics, so can be used in various ways. But generally, he said the rocket mask can be used in so many ways in the game to give more variety to the knight's right action. But with dropping mask and dragon mask, it can be used to get the hidden items and stuff.
Yeah.
Not really for general use, but what you think of it though? Yeah. So, でも一番好きなのって言ったら、それはロケットになるんですか？
いやだからそのユーザーに対しておすすめできるのは、
So he would recommend the most is rocket mask. Maybe it depends
on what you're doing.
Yeah. Rocket mask has a possibility to create your own strategy. So
flying.
Okay. That is useful. But form is my favorite is dragon. Yeah, dragon is totally different from others.
Design.
So I like the dragon form.
Okay. Yeah. I really like that one as well. Looks really good. When I was playing the game a little while ago, I noticed that when you finished a level, or it said night over, that the number changed, the amount of days changed. Does that have any effect in the game later on, or what? Why is that there?
セガサターンで時計を書いてたやつで今回も Wii でも買えるかってことですよね。
あの時計なんかそうやって日付が出るんですよね、クリアしたらっていう。でなんか日付とかなんかセガナイツオーバーってなった時になんか出るって言ってた。 Sorry, what was the question?
There's a counter in the game
The nights.
Nights.
Number of nights.
Number of nights you've done,
yeah.
The number of days have passed.
Ah, 56 nights and...
Yeah.
So that's... それが何か影響するかと。
Yeah, そうです。
No.
No, sorry, no. No, any...
あれ、だからどれだけ自分が、あれはこのプレイヤーを選んでから、ドリームゲートに入ってきた回数がカウントされるんですね。
This is number of... a number of times you entered Dream Gate. That's just the number.
Okay.
ということで、その自分がどれだけこのゲームを遊んだかっていうそのレコード。
So you can see how many you played the game.
Yeah, just for records.
Yes.
In the original Nights, when you change the date on the Saturn console, gameplay sometimes changes in the game. Is there a feature like that? Yeah. Is there an internal plot feature within Journey of Dreams?
まあ今回は実際の本編ではそのクロックフューチャー使ってないですけど、まあそれは。当時セガサターンでクロックフューチャーを使うっていうのは他でやってない新しいことだったから、まあ、入れたんですけど、まあ、今回ではまた同じことをやるんじゃなくてまた他にやってない何かをやりたいということで、まあ、今回フォーキャスチャンネルっていうのをやりました。
いや、やりました、
はい、で一応時計機能もそのマイドリームの毎月のイベント、その一環として、まあ、時計機能も使ってます、そこで。
Okay. He is not using the clock, internal clock feature in Journey of Dreams. He added in original night because it was a really new feature and he wanted to do something really, he wanted to challenge something new.So that's why he added. But for this title, as a new challenge, he added a web focus channel.
Okay.
Yeah, and also in my dream, also the clock feature is available. That gives you, you will see the seasonal events in my dream.
Oh,
so,
okay.
Yeah. For example, if in Christmas, maybe the creature, the costume of the creature will change. You will see the Halloween. You will see a lot of world events in
your dream. Okay.
Every month.
Every month. Look forward to.
So you have to keep checking.
Just recently, the news has come out that.The original Knights is going to come on PlayStation 2 in Japan. First of all, is that going to happen all over the world? And then, is there a possibility it could come onto Nintendo Wii on the Virtual Console, or could it be released on other?
Well,
are we going to see that game over here on PS2?
初めにそれが使えない。こっちでも売られますかってことと、それがバーチャルコンソールになることって言われたんですかってことですね。
まあまず、まあ海外で。 まあ、今のところ売ることはなくて、まあ、それは日本でクラシックタイトルを PS にするっていうシリーズ、まあ、その流れとして、まあ、今日本で、まあ、そのプロジェクトが動いているか、で、まあ、その後のポシビリティの話で言えば、今のところまだ何もその後のプランはありません。だけど、まあ、ポシビリティで言えば今後 の、 あの展開として、まあ、なくはないと言っちゃっていいのかな。
テクニカ
ルに、まあ、今のところまだその後の話は考えてない。
いや、あ、考えてないです
ね。考えてない。
はい。firstly, there's no plan to release the PS2 original night in Europe. Sorry. that happened because there is a project of remaking the Sega Classic title in Japan, in and there are so many demand for the original nights in Japan that that's why it we could make it happen. But for Europe, no plan for now. And and also for regarding the virtual console version, also we don't.Have any plans to do that for now?
Okay.
So far.
So no Wii version planned at all.
So far. So far.
Wii version console. Right. Huh? Yeah.
Possibility.
One more question.
One more.
Yeah.
Sorry. I'll let you find.
You got a good one.
good one. Bear in mind the last one. In Nights of the Dreams, the Nightopians, for people who played the game obsessively, there was the ability to get a very rare Nightopian, a King or Super Nightopian.
Oh, you mean you can get special Nightopian?
Yes, special. Yes, will there be any similar sort of special rare Nightopian?
なんか特別なナイトピアンをゲットできますか、そういうのあるんですか。
ナイトピアン、A ライフたちっていうのはそもそもエネミーであるナイトメアンと合体することによってもう本当に数え切れないぐらいのバリエーションのメアンが生まれるんですね。
メアン、はい。
なんかそのバリエーション、メアンのバリエーションはもう本当にたくさんあるので、まあ、まずそれがあるのとっていうのと、あとまあ前作にスーパーピアンっていうのがいたんですけど、まあ、あのスーパーピアンっていうのは今回のジャニー・オブ・ドリームズでも登場します。
おお、言っちゃっていいんですか。
それ言っちゃっていいです。
OK、Basically, you can create your own creature. It's called Man, by mixing with Nightopians and Nightomans. SoYeah, so there are a lot of, you can make a lot of type of your creatures, mans. So there's no special characters, but there will also be super pians, which was in also original night.That will be available as well.
Well, yes,
yeah, Superman.
Superpian.
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 Sorry.
Don't.
Superpian.
Superpian.
Yep. That makes sense.
Thanks, guys.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Yeah.